about verbally violent media today while addressing the gathering.
So, I talked about
Verbally violent media, reporters shouting in front of the screen and everything. What are your views on Arnab Goswami? As
who's she?
Arnab Goswami.
Who's she? Is it a boy or a girl?
It's a man. It's a man.
Oh, the fellow who screams on television.
Yes, yes.
India that wants guy. To know.
Republic. He screams. What views do you want me to have?
Okay.
I don't. I don't see that gender at all.
So, what according to you is your spirit animal?
Is mine?
Spirit animal. An animal you relate with on a spiritual level or?
The elephant.
The elephant. Why so?
It's the national elephant, the national animal of India.
Just that.
And the tiger.
Okay.
The grace, the beauty, the speed. And for the elephant, it's the sheer tenacity.
Okay. So, sir, what is the best advice that you've ever received from a person?
It was from my wife. So, go talk to your lawyer.
Alright.
The best advice was from my mother. She said, just know yourself, be yourself. And don't do anything that would embarrass you the next minute. Look straight into your eyes. If you have to lower your eyes, don't.
So that does make sense on a very relatable level. So, move on to our next question.
Yes. So what is the best advice that you've ever given to someone?
Which I'm giving you now. The great Tunisian Carthaginian emperor, Hannibal, 2200 years ago, his father Hasdrubal had been killed by the Romans. So he wanted to take revenge. He had 27 war elephants. He decided to drive them through the Alps. His generals called him, came to him and said, Your Majesty, it can't be done. He said, Why? He said, There is no way. And then Hannibal answered, I will either find a way. That is my advice. Impossible is nothing. People say nothing is impossible. My take is impossible is nothing.
That's a very noble chain of thought.
It's not a noble chain of thought, it's a very realistic chain of thought.
Yeah, noble and realistic.
You can achieve anything that you want. When I share khudi ko kar buland itna ki agli taqdeer se pehle khuda khud tujhse puche bata क्या लिखो इसके बाद?
Yes sir.
मैंने लिख ली लेकिन अभी फिर से भारतवासी लोग.
Okay sir. Sir, which novel, regardless of the genre, would you recommend to the new generation of India to study?
पढ़िए हरिवंश राय बच्चन की किताब है. पढ़िए all the great Indians, Sumitra Nandan Pant. Read whatever. Read Kalidas. Read writers from around the world, read Subramanya Bharati, read from the Northeast. There's nothing in particular that I would recommend. Just get to know the diversity of India as an incredible country. This mosaic, this multi-hued jewel, we call it India.
And what would be your personal favorite novel?
My life. They're all my favorite.
So what do you feel is lacking in the new generation of India?
Nothing. You are the best generation that we've had. This is the best time to be young in India. Aur isiliye mera favorite song aapne suna hoga. Main aksar gungunata hoon. Koi lauta de mere beete hue din. This is really the time to be young in India. The world is at your feet. Go out. Conquer the world with love, with wisdom, not with violence. Show them what India is all about. You can do it. There are challenges. You can't solve those challenges with the mindsets that created them. We need new perspectives. You can do it. And the advice I give you, don't believe anyone who says you are the future. You are the present. start with yourself.
Yeah.
Even if all the others, not I, etiam seam as everyone, let the others do what they want. I will be faithful to myself.
Thank you, sir. Sir, your name is synonymous with exemplary oration. Are there any tips that you'd like to extend to the viewers?
The day that you start thinking with your heart and feeling with your mind, you have arrived.
Okay, sir. With that, we come to an end of the interview.
Oh, that's a very quick interview.
Yes.
You thought that 2-3 hours will take?
No, sir. No.
Many of you, for those who are looking for careers, you know, there's no job that is unimportant, none that is very important. You may not be where you want to be, you will be where you were meant to be. So carry on with whatever you are doing. Serve India in your own way. Every contribution that you make is significant. Leave India better than you found it, because you have a responsibility to build for yourselves a better India to live in, and to bequeath to your children a better India to inherit. You will be mothers of India one day. Bring up your children in a way that they become proud citizens of a magnificent country. You know what we call that country?
India.
We call it India. They call it India. What would I be if I were not in India? I can't even contemplate existence outside India. Of course, we have challenges, shortcomings, usada, yada, whatever. But the essence, our soul is in the right place, our heart is in the right place. Yours are. My heart I lost many years ago. She took me. I married her, still married her. 41 years. Same model. Yeah, as Indians, honesty, courage, and wisdom. And if you can imbibe these three values, spread a little bit of sunshine wherever you go and see the result. Because ultimately, the goodness in you will enter the others who may not be as good and come back to you many times more. A manifold increase, you will see it happen.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Yes.
Head girl, madam?
Yes, sir.
Yatra Kenya?
Yeah, because.